Hey everybody, Merry Christmas and welcome to the Countdown to Christmas. Tonight's viewing, we're going to be reading Christmas classics. And I've got a book for you that I'm going to be reading the first chapter out of called The Holiday Tree, written by this guy named Mark Rempel. This book was an inspiration for me when it came to this idea of what the meaning of Christmas is all about. And rather than just try to write a sermon, I tried to write a story for my family to remind them that no matter what, never lose the unshakable power of what the season is all about. And that is the meaning of Christmas, Christ coming into the world. So I would like to read a few pages for you and let you know that you can pick the book up at $29.11. You can order on Amazon. Or for $19.95, you can get 20 of them. But I'm honored you're with us. And so sit back, grab a cup of hot cocoa, coffee, whatever. Grab a friend, family member, and enjoy being read to. Chapter 1, Ellsworth. Happy holidays! Happy holidays to you! A 4'3" Grace Livingston cried with excitement before pushing the glass door open. A gust of cold air blew through her shoulder-length, dark brown hair and nearly took her breath away as she stepped outside William's Drug and Hardware Store on the corner of Main and Dandelion in the quaint village of Ellsworth. A picturesque sort of town in the deep rolling hills of the upper eastern United States. She waved a furry red mitten in front of the picture window. Bella Crabtree Williams, the wife of longtime owner George, was standing in front of. Bella waved back. She pointed at the bright lights on the fake holiday tree reflecting on the window glass. Grace smiled. The lights danced in her eyes, reminding her that this truly was her favorite time of year. She turned and skipped along Ellsworth's main street, paying close attention not to step away or on any of the sidewalk cracks. Several big snowflakes landed on her cheek before she could catch them on her tongue. The bright red furry earmuffs and matching jacket were keeping her warmer than she expected, warm enough to take a detour through downtown Ellsworth just so she could see the lights and sounds of the season.
Well, hello there, Grace,
a frail older woman said with a warm greeting before Grace could pass her.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Sampson,
Grace replied, stopping long enough to get a glimpse of the beautifully wrapped package that Mrs. Sampson was holding.
Who is the present for?
She asked, secretly hoping it was for her. She imagined the exact place it would be sitting beneath the Livingston holiday tree.
Oh, it's for my nephew, Charles. He's coming home for the holidays, you know. He's been stationed out there in Tucson or Tuscan, whatever you say, for a while. Army base. Sad place to celebrate the holidays during such a beautiful season. All those cacti and all that sand. I'd rather have 10 inches of snow. Don't you just love this time of year, Grace? I think it snowed just for you,
she said to Grace, who was twirling on her feet and with her tongue standing straight up in the air.
Uh-huh,
Grace grunted while catching a big white flake and pulling it inside her warm mouth.
I like all the holiday lights. Oh, they're sure magical, aren't they? And did you know they're going to light up the big spruce tree across at the annual Ellsworth Holiday Tree lighting this Thursday?
The old woman said, with pure excitement.
Yeah, my class is going to sing at it,
Grace gleamed. Her smile was one front tooth short of a complete set of adult teeth.
And what is it your class is going to be singing?
Grace bit her lip and thought for a moment.
We're doing Oh Holiday Tree and We Wish You a Merry Holiday.
Yeah, We Wish You a Merry Holiday. That's my favorite.
Well, well, there you go then. I'm making a beautiful holiday cake for that night, and I'll make sure I save a piece for you. I'm decorating a beautiful star out of frosting to sit right on top of that cake.
Mm-hmm, Grace replied, snatching another snowflake between her lips.
See you Thursday, honey. I need to get going. I have a few more gifts to buy, Mrs. Sampson said,
trailing off into the coffee cup, Ellsworth's only coffee and pastry shop.
Bye, Mrs. Sampson,
Grace waved.
She started skipping down the sidewalk again, singing loudly and trying to catch the yummy flakes on her tongue. We wish you a happy holiday. We wish you a happy holiday. We wish you a happy holiday and a happy new year. Downtown Ellsworth was garnished in all the holiday flair. Store windows were clad in seasonal colors with bright lights, tinsel, and several versions of the season's greatest mascot, Santa. Grace pushed her nose and lips onto a frosty window pane, staring at a mechanical moving Santa that pretended to write down a name or two. Grace tried reading the words from the top of the scroll hanging from Santa's hand. H-O-L-I-D-A-Y. Holiday list. Grace smiled with anticipation at the fake Santa. She worked extra hard at being good this year, following her mother's commands and checking off her chore list every Saturday morning. She hoped she had done enough good stuff to score some really nice gifts straight from Santa's workshop at the North Pole. Her eyes twinkled at the reflection of light spilling across the glass her face was pressed against. Inside Ellsworth City Park, nearly 300,000 lights displayed, a sight that drew thousands of gawkers from the entire northern state every year. Trees were caked in red, white, green, orange, and blue lights. Every evergreen on the five-acre park site was clothed with colorful electricity, not to mention the display of nearly 100 plastic snowmen. The biggest one stood a proud 10 feet tall. A sign blinked the words, Happy Holidays, tied between two poles on the top of a white gazebo that sat smack dab in the middle of the holiday light extravaganza. The only feature that wasn't dressed with lights was the 25-foot blue spruce, freshly cut and sent from Upper Maine, that would be the focal point of this year's 50th annual holiday tree light display. It stood tall in all of its glory, the tree that is, perfectly pedicured in an East Coast forest. It was round at the bottom and tapered beautifully towards the top. The branches seemed evenly spaced, except for a few spots towards the middle. Even so, it took a critical stare and a cynical spirit to find all the imperfections. As far as Grace was concerned, it was perfect. She stood back and took in the tree's towering presence. It had an eerie, magical appearance, standing in the dark. She couldn't wait till Thursday's tree lighting ceremony. She read the sign out loud that was hanging like an ornament near the base of the tree. Ellsworth's 50th annual holiday tree lighting. Holiday, she pondered. What does that mean anyway? A gentle wind brushed against her face, along with a few lingering snowflakes, reminding her that dinner would soon be ready. See you Thursday, she hollered at the tree before waving goodbye to it. The spruce's wind-blown branches almost appeared to wave back. While walking home, Grace tried to take in all the holiday cheer Ellsworth had to offer. The shops, the windows, the lights, and Santa and his 8 tiny reindeer. A loudspeaker wired outside Millie's sandwich shop piped out one of her favorite seasonal songs. She sang it at the top of her lungs without much pitch. But for Grace, pitch was never a factor when singing songs that seemed to visit like her aunt did once a year. These songs were special, and they deserved a good, loud shout. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, she sang loudly. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe will help to make a season bright. Tiny tots, that's me, with their eyes all aglow, will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. although it's been said many times, many ways. Happy holidays to you. And that's it for chapter one. You can read the rest of the book, The Holiday Tree.
Yes.